Assalamu alaikum. My name is Ahmed, and today on stepforward.com we will be looking at cookies in general and specific to PHP also. So first of all, let's understand what cookies really are. Cookies are basically text files that are created by the browser and that are stored on the client side. That is, the web browser, any browser, will create a file on its end, not on the server end, on its end, and store some value in it. HTTP protocol is responsible for sending a request to create a cookie with the data from the server to the client side, and in case of retrieving the value, it will be responsible for reading, asking the browser for the cookie value to be read and taking that value back to the web server. Information once stored can later be read by the server machine. Of course, that is the main purpose of using cookies, that instead of storing all the values and all the variables maintained on the server side, we are also going to save some information on the client side for most probably later references. Then information stored in a cookie can live even if the user closes the website, go back home, sleeps, come back the next day and open the site, and the value will still remain there. Of course, if the settings are made such. So first of all, let's graphically understand how cookies will work. We have a client side, that is the web browser, and we have the web server side, that is Apache in our case. And if in PHP the setCookie function is called, what this function will do, that it will request the client machine using HTTP protocol to, along with the data, to save this particular data with this name on your site. And the browser will basically create a file on its end, and save the value. Later on, if on the web server the cookie array, one of the super global arrays, is called using the same name, what will happen? This request is sent to the client side, the browser will read the cookie and send the value back to the web server. This is how cookie will work. So this comes and this opens another question, that are cookies really safe, because we are allowing the server to create files on the client machine. So basically, each browser has its own set of cookies. Firefox will not be reading cookies of Chrome, and Chrome will not be reading the cookies of Firefox. Then each website can read only its own cookies. For instance, site1.com will not be able to read the cookies saved by stepforward.com, and vice versa also. Then each particular cookie is only limited to a size of maximum 4 kilobytes. Any cookie cannot be, so that the server doesn't just start dumping data to the client side. The maximum size of any cookie can be 4 kilobytes. Then most browsers allow maximum of 20 cookies per site. This includes the domain and the subdomains also. And finally, most browsers, in a total counting all the cookies stored from any domain, the total is 3300, that is the allowed figure. So if a single domain has crossed its limit of 20 cookies, or the overall threshold has crossed 300, any particular old cookie will be deleted first and a new cookie will be created. So how long cookies will live? For this rules, this is governed by a parameter that is created by the set cookie method, and that is, the expiry time is provided whenever a cookie is created. Cookies are deleted, of course, when that expiry time has been passed. Sorry, this is a spelling mistake, I can understand any and off. Server can delete the cookie by giving any time that has already passed. And then if no time was given, this value will be deleted, this cookie variable will be deleted when the browser window will be closed. The client can also manually delete any cookie, that is using the browser interface. So that's the end of the presentation. Let's go to our web browser, Firefox we have over here, and let's open our GEditor. So first of all, let's create a cookie. Cookies should always be created and read at the top before giving any data to the browser or using any PHP echo statement. So as I mentioned that, first of all, let's create a variable site name stepforward.com, and now let's ask this to be saved. So there are two things. First of all, what name do you want to give to this cookie? I will call it site underscore name. And second, what value do you want to give to this cookie? Of course, I can give any value, but let's give the value from this variable. Save it. And let's keep it simple for the time being. I will not give the expiry time over here. Let's go down and let's echo a statement that cookie has been created. Save. Go to Firefox. Refresh the page. Cookie has been created. Now, where this cookie has been created? This is the question. So, in my case, this is Ubuntu machine and I'm using Firefox browser. So, if I go to my home page, open a new tab, and under my home page, there's a hidden folder Mozilla. If I open it up, there are two folders, Firefox. If I open it up, this folder, this weird looking folder, open this up, you can see that there are 1-2 files of cookies, and this is probably something happened, so some cookies were rebuilt anyway. So previously browsers literally created text files for cookies, but nowadays, for instance, Firefox is using SQLite database for creating cookies, so that the user cannot manually change the value of cookies. Or and the second reason is that since these values are indexed, so retrieval is very fast anyway. Now let's go to our web browser and see how we can use it. If I go to the menu, edit, preferences, on the fifth tab, privacy, I have an option, accept cookies from site. Yep, we want to accept, and we can give exceptions also. This accept third-party cookies, yes, that's also allowed. And still, how long cookies should be kept till they expire, that is the value given by the cookie, or I close Firefox, or ask me every time. So you see, user is provided with a lot of flexibility. We can also have a view of the cookies, show cookies, and let me type here site 1, and you can see there's a cookie available of site 1. Click over here, this is the name of the cookie, these are the contents of the cookies, the host, the path, and when will this be expired. So at the end of the session. So let's close it down, and now let's give it a value, an expiry value. Expiry value can be any value from the current time. For instance, we in the previous video we saw how time is used in PHP, how we can manipulate time, and we can then give it a value of, for instance, this is in seconds, so I can give it a value of 60 seconds multiply by 60, that makes 1 hour. Okay, so this cookie will live for 1 hour. Save it, go back, refresh this page, hopefully it has been refreshed, yes. Go to preferences, show cookies, site1.com, here's the cookie, and if you see the current time is 6:25 and I gave it a expiry time of 1 hour. So after 1 hour, this value will be automatically deleted. How we can retrieve the values of cookies? We can retrieve the value of any cookie by simply, let's comment it out for now. By simply using the array, the super array, cookie array. Let's give it a value of site name and store it in a variable. save it, go over here, refresh this page. Cookie has been retrieved and this is the value of the cookie. Now I mentioned that we can only be shown or we can only read cookies that were saved by us. For instance, let's create few more cookies. Let's comment it out. And site name, just give it a expiry time of just 1 minute. And let's save another cookie. Site slogan, get ahead of the rest. Same time has been given. Save it, go to the browser, refresh this page, open it up in this window, show cookies, and let's go right down. Yep, this is site1.com and I can see that I have two cookies in site1.com. This is one, it will be expired at 1 minute, after 1 minute, and this is the other, it will be expired at 1 minute. If I retrieve these values using the array, save it, go back, refresh, these are the values of this cookie. And interestingly, only my values, the values I stored, have been shown. This is because I, in the beginning, I told you that how cookies will work. So the time is about to pass, and hopefully the seconds will also work. Refresh this page. You see, the value has been deleted now. No more cookies exist. So how can we know that if a cookie value exists or not? Let's get rid of all this. And we can simply use if statement is set, and in this part we can just say that does this value exist. Go back, refresh this page, and this is giving me an error. What is this error? Yes, semicolon missing. Refresh this page. Nope, it doesn't exist. Now let's create it then. Let's give it some more value. 5 minutes. Sorry. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Save. Back, refresh, and we see it is telling me that yes, the cookie does exist. And if I go down to this, the other way was that I can simply delete a cookie from here, just clicking over here. This is one way of deleting a cookie. Another way of deleting was that if we set a value of negative, that is at any time of the past, save it. If I go over here, refresh this page, and it is telling me yes, the cookie has been deleted, so it doesn't exist anymore. So this is a basic functionality of how cookies work, and this provide a lot of powerful way of giving the option to users that once a user visits your site, makes some settings, goes back, comes back the next day, you can simply save those settings in cookies on the client side, and the next day when he'll come, you can read the cookies, and he will be having the same experience as he had the previous day. So hopefully this tutorial was very helpful to you.